We are live. So, oh my. No, let's not do this now, please. Awesome. Yeah. All right, I'm just adjusting. Hello, beautiful humans. My name's Kaui, like Molly, only with K, and we're going to have so much fun today. A couple of things before we get started. This is what we're painting this afternoon, but listen, if there's anything in this painting that you would like to change, like perhaps, for example, your sparklers here are not red and yellow and blue. Maybe you have a purple sparkler, or maybe all of your sparklers are green. Maybe you don't have a blue background. Maybe your background is purple. Whatever lives in your painting lives in your painting. Okay, it's your creation. I just want you to do what makes you happy within reason. I'm in my studios and I have a tendency to splash. So just be wary of your surroundings. Please try really hard not to splash your neighbor or your walls. Today we are using a number 12. Wash brush. We are using a number 6 round brush, and we are using a number 1 round brush. Also, just a heads up, like, if this is a 16 by 20 inch canvas, but whatever you are using or are comfortable with, it is completely up to you. Okay, so a couple of other things, you guys. This is about fun. This is not about telling everybody how terrible you are at art. Okay, don't talk to yourself like that. So if at any point in time you feel the need to criticize or berate yourself either, please do us all a favor and step away from the painting. Okay, walk around. Grab a drink, maybe something to snack on. I paint really fast, okay? So if I get ahead of you, please feel free to put me on pause and come back when you're ready to continue forward. I think that's it. And with that, we toast. This is my coffee. To coffee. Ching, ching, baby. All right. So for all of you that need to know everything we're going to do before we do it, here's what's going to happen. We're going to take our big, giant Mac Daddy brush. It is your biggest, most giant Mac Daddy brush. We're going to paint our entire canvas blue. Okay. Then we are going to brighten up this center here with white. Just a heads up, your OCD is going to yell at you. I apologize in advance if you actually have OCD. I apologize now. Probably going to say that a lot. You are going to want to fix it. I want you to try really hard not to fix it, okay? This is just going to be a streaky mess. And then we are going to paint our edges black. And we're going to blend the colors together. Okay, so also, just a heads up, your perfectionist will yell at you. Okay, I want you to just try really hard to just let it go. Okay. It should be uneven. It should be crooked. It should be super messy. And we want it that way. Okay. So, on your mark, get set, go. Let's get started, shall we? Okay, guys, so the first thing we're going to do is paint our entire canvas blue. And to do that, I'm going to use my biggest brush here. For all of our paintings in the Art and Sip, we use 3 brushes. Any more than that is just too much. So I'm going to take a big glob of paint here. Whatever color you want, I'm going to use blue. And I'm going to paint this entire thing blue. Okay, try not to think about it too much. Just wherever you got room. Splat, 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 splat. Please be careful not to splash your walls or your neighbors if you are painting with others. Again, try not to think about it too much. You run out of paint, load up again. It is super hot in the desert. I maybe shouldn't have painted right next to my window. Let's see if it makes a difference. Not really, huh? Dang. Oh, well. All right, my beautiful humans, I realize that I paint really fast. So this next part here is going to be brightening up this center here. From here, if you need to put me on pause, please do so. Come back when you are ready, but I'm going to take my same big giant Mac Daddy brush. I'm going to load it up with white and I'm going to paint the center here. Just to brighten it up a little bit. Okay, so same dirty brush, white, and this whole entire center, we are just gonna brighten up. Okay, just a heads up, your OCD probably is gonna yell at you. You are gonna wanna fix it. I just want you to be wary that if you go over it and 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 over it, notice the blob. Okay, there's no coming back from the blob, so I want you to try really hard to streak it and leave it alone. I know, easier said than done, Kaui. But that's what I want. That's what you want to, even though you don't know it yet. Just kidding, I don't know what you want. I do want you to do what makes you happy, though, so. If you are one of those who is a stickler for directions, I want you to try really hard to just let it go. Excuse me. Okay, so from here, we're going to come back in with black. We're going to paint our edges. Okay, so just a heads up, like, we are going to do this perimeter, okay? And then we're gonna paint the line where our blue meets our black, okay? It is gonna get really blurry. Your perfectionist is going to yell at you. You are gonna wanna fix it. I want you to try really hard not to fix it, okay? All right, so from here, again, if you need to put me on pause, I realize I paint really fast. I've done this for a long time. So if you need to put me on pause, please do so now. But I'm going to take my same big giant Mac Daddy brush. I'm going to give it a good rinse my water. Nice and clean, nice and clean. Swish, 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 swish. I'm going to tap it out. I'm going to blot it on my towel. I'm going to load it up with black. And you guys, I'm just going to paint my edges. And like this space. Okay? Around here. All the way to the edges. Okay? If you need to mark out your space, go for it. If not, that's okay too. I'm gonna start with my corners here. I think it's cool painting like this too. Sometimes when I'm painting, my canvas sounds like a drum. And you guys, you don't need too much paint. Like, we don't want a whole lot of black paint, because what you will end up finding is that your black will overpower everything else on your canvas. Okay, so just a tiny, tiny bit. I loaded up my paintbrush maybe twice, and it was just splat, splat. Okay, like I didn't scoop it up like a spoon. I just splat, splat, splat. That's all I needed. And mostly the fluidity is because my paint is already wet. Okay, like I didn't have to do a whole lot. All right, so there's our frame. And then from here, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna blend this edge, okay? Where my black meets my blue, we're gonna haze out this line. Okay, again, try not to think about it too much. If you wanna curse at me, you can. No one will hear you. Or maybe they will, but at least they'll know that you're talking to me, right? Just kidding. Okay, so from here, same big giant Mac Daddy brush. I'm gonna rinse mine off really, really good. Okay, like nice and clean, nice and clean. Push down, swish hard. In my classes, I like to say violently swish your brush, because usually my attendees are like, it's clean, and it's not, right? It's still caked with goop. So push down, swish hard, swish it hard. And I'm going to tap it out, and I'm going to blot it on my towel. And using a clean, damp brush, I am just going to blend this line, okay? Until you kind of can't see where the black ends and the blue begins. And you guys, you are going to pick up all of your paint. You can curse at me in the comments if you want to. I'll understand. Okay, so we made it kind of messy. I'm gonna rinse my brush again, okay? And use like all of the excess paint that I just picked up. I'm gonna rinse it off my brush, nice and clean, nice and clean. I'm gonna tap it out, I'm gonna blot it on my towel, and I am just going to haze out this line. Try not to think about it too much. I know I keep saying that, but I'm saying it because you're doing a hard job. And you guys, it doesn't have to be a circle. Like, if you don't have a circle frame, that's okay. You do sort of want to get kind of loose with it, okay? Like, I want you to allow yourself permission to just let it go. Because what's going to happen next is we're going to come back in with our sparklers. And we need a dark space for our sparklers to shine. Okay, so if you got black everywhere, that's okay. Perhaps you need a little bit more blue in here. Everything that we're doing right now, we are going to paint over it. So try to let it go. Let it be messy. Let it be streaky. We are going to cut in our perfectly straight lines. When we get to our mason jar, we are going to cut in our perfectly straight lines. When we get to our sparkler, but for right now, we just need a place for our jar and our sparklers to go. Ooh, look at our perfect portal there. Beautiful. All right, guys. So from here, I'm going to use my hairdryer. Oh, excuse me, to go over this. All right, my beautiful humans. So from here, what we're going to do is we are going to paint in just a place marker for where our jar is going to go. And you guys, it doesn't have to be a mason jar, okay? Like, it can, perhaps you have a pretty perfume bottle, or maybe you have a vase or a shape that you're fond of. I mean, maybe you want to put it in a pumpkin, who knows? But what we're going to do is we're going to map out our glass using light blue. Okay. And if you get ahead of me, we're going to map out our glass in light blue. We're going to put in our sparkler sticks here. We're going to do the pom-pom part of our sparkler. And then we're going to come back to our jar to re-establish our lines. But this time with white, we are going to use our teeny tiny princess brush for this and our stems here. And just a heads up too, like, I want you to think about the colors that you want to use for your sparkler. Also, I will probably be using my finger to do these really bright pieces here in the middle. If you don't want to use your finger, you don't want to get dirty, go ahead and use your medium brush. All right, on your mark, get set, go. All right, so first, our mason jar. Okay, to do the mason jar, and again, we are just marking it out. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to swirl together a lot of white and a little bit of my blue until I get the light blue that I like. Okay, so I don't know if you can see this, but this is my light blue. Okay, I like it. I'm going to go with it. And you guys, I'm going to just basically mark out where I want my cup to go. Okay, so I want my cup to go in the middle. So I'm going to put the mouth of my jar right here. Okay. If you mess up and you need to adjust, now is the time. Okay, that's why we're marking it out with blue. If later you want to scribble scrabble over the lines, perhaps this is a little bit too small. You want to make it bigger. Or maybe it's too big. You want to make it smaller. It's totally up to you. But we are marking it out so that later, when we really accentuate those lines, they will pop. All right, so same teeny tiny princess brush. Blue, my same blue. I want the lip of my jar to come down to about there. Okay, I'm gonna connect it back. So we've got a guideline for our highlight to go. Okay, and the re-up again. And my mason jar kind of has like a curvy top to it. Then it comes straight down to the bottom. Oh yeah, you guys too, if these skid marky things happen to you, basically they mean that you don't have enough paint on your brush or your brush is too dry. So either, you know, dip your brush in some water to extend the life of your paint. Or get more paint. All right. There's my jar all the way down to the bottom. Maybe, yeah, that's good. On my mason jar here. I also kind of want to put in a little emblem on my jar. Sometimes there's a ball on it, sometimes there's not. In this case, I don't really want to do the 1776, so I'm just going to put my date of birth, which is 1982, just in case you were wondering. So here's my marker out where my little emblem is. I will put 1982 here. 82 was a good year. It doesn't have to be perfect. Again, we are going to paint over it. If you feel like yours is a little bit off or you need to adjust, do it. Allow yourself permission to just let it go. Okay, so from here, we are going to put the sticks in of our sparkler. So I'm going to take my same teeny tiny princess brush. I'm going to rinse it off really, really good. Nice and clean, nice and clean. I'm going to tap it out. I'm going to blot it on my towel there. And I'm just going to use my black. I'm going to decide where my sticks belong. Maybe I've got one here. My black is a little bit too solid. Also, yeah, you guys, if you have the consistency, if your black or your paint, if your paint is the consistency of a toothpaste and you at this point are not using it as a sort of plaster for the texture, you want the consistency of a syrup or a ketchup. Okay, so if yours has seized up to a toothpaste, go ahead and drip a little bit of water. Give it a little shimmy. So it's easier to work with. All right, there's my first sparkler. I'm gonna put the sparkler right here. Bet you guys, wherever your happy little sparkler belongs. Okay, there's no right answer. Maybe you only have one or two. Maybe you've got five. It's totally up to you. However many sparklers live in your painting is however many sparklers live in your painting. Okay. From here, we are going to do these sparkly guys. Okay. And what's going to happen is we are going to paint the color with our medium brush. A dabble do ya. Okay. You're just going to decide what color you want to do. I'm going to just stick with the painting and do red, yellow, and blue. But perhaps, for example, you have orange sparklers or purple sparklers or green sparklers. Whatever color you want to do is whatever color is the right color. Okay, there's no right answer. It really is whatever color makes you happy. But what we're going to do is we're going to make blots, okay? And then we're going to scribble scrabble out that edge. We're going to make it a little bit hazy so it gives the illusion of our shine there. Okay, so I'm going to start with red because why not? I'm going to use my medium brush here. It's a number 6 round brush. I'm going to load it up with my red. I'm going to make my little puffball. My little puffball goes right here. However big or small you want your puffball to be. Okay. And then from here, I'm just going to pull out the edges so they kind of look furry. Try not to think about it too much. It shouldn't be even. It should be crooked. It should be off. Your perfectionist should be yelling at you. Okay? Just let it yell at you. All right. There's my pretty fuzzball there. It's crooked. It's uneven. I'm going to let it be. So same medium brush. I'm going to rinse it off really, really good. Nice and clean, nice and clean. Swish, 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 swish. I'm going to tap it out. I'm going to blot it on my towel. And you guys, like, violently swish your brush, okay? Like, swish hard. Push down, swish hard. All right. Same medium brush. It's nice and clean. I cleaned it off really, really good. I tapped it out. I blotted it on my towel. I'm loading it up with yellow. And my next fuzzball goes right here. Okay. However big or small it is, I want kind of a big puffball. And I think I'm going to turn this one orange just so it looks a little more yellow on the camera there. I guess we'll see what happens. Looks the same. Okay. So again, however big or small your sparkler is, there's no right answer. And I'm going to fur it up a little bit. Okay. So as if I was checking something off a list, you're just going to floof, 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 floof. Try not to think about it too much. All right, there is my yellow sparkler. Next, we're gonna do blue. So I'm gonna take my same medium brush here. I'm gonna rinse off really, really good. Nice and clean, nice and clean. I'm gonna load it up with blue. I'm gonna do my last fuzzball here. All right, same medium brush, blue. My fuzzball goes right here. I'm gonna circle it out however big or small I want my fuzzy guy to be. And I'm just gonna pull out the edges. Oh, I got some black in my fuzzball. I'm just gonna go with it. I'm okay with it. All right, I've got my fuzzies. Okay, so while our paint is still wet, what we're gonna do is we're gonna go back over these little fuzzies, but with white, okay? Just a heads up, you are gonna pick up all of your paint, okay? You are gonna wanna fix it. I want you to try really hard not to fix it, because we're gonna come back in again once our paint is drier and sort of reestablish that bright spot, okay, as well as all the sparks around it. Yeah, just a heads up, you are going to want to fix it. I want you to try really hard not to fix it, okay? So I'm going to take my same medium brush here. I'm going to rinse it off really, really good, nice and clean, nice and clean. I'm going to tap it out. I'm going to blot it on my towel. I'm going to dunk it in my white, and I'll just start with the red just because why not? All right, so same medium brush, white. I'm going to splat in the middle of my little sparkler there, and I'm just going to pull out, okay, in whichever direction I want to go. Maybe you want to stay with your little sparkle trail there. That's okay. Maybe you want to go in a completely different direction. That's okay too. Okay. If it goes out and over your lines, that's okay. It's a sparkler. It should. Okay. So if yours does, let it go. All right. So I'm going to do it again, but this time with the yellow, same dirty brush. I'm going to rinse it off really good. I'm going to come back in. I'm going to do the same thing again with white. All right, nice and clean, nice and clean. I realize this camera probably doesn't have the best attention to detail here, but hopefully you get the idea. All right, so same medium brush, white. I'm gonna dot the center of my yellow here. And I'm gonna do the same. Make my fuzzy little firecracker here. That's how I imagine it would sound. And you guys, this is just to brighten up our sparkler. Okay, it doesn't have to be perfect. It should not be even. Okay, so I don't want you to spend a whole lot of time making sure you have perfect circles or perfect fuzzballs, okay? There is no such thing at this point. Seriously. Okay, so blue is next. Same medium brush. I rinsed it off really, really good. I tapped it out. I blotted it on my paper towel. I mean my towel. My rag. It's a rag, actually. I load it up with white. I'm going to dot the center again. And the same, I'm going to do the same thing. Go ahead and make the sound effect if you have to. Oftentimes, I find it helps when you're making paintings. When you're painting there to get into it. Sometimes you got to make the noise, yeah? Beautiful. Okay, again, you guys, if from here you're already like, slow down, like put me on pause and then come back, okay? All right, the next part that we're gonna do is our jar, okay? And to do our jar, we are gonna take our teeny tiny princess brush and we're gonna go back over all of our initial mark it out lines, okay? We're gonna go over them in white and then we're gonna come back in and we're gonna do some of these highlights here in our jar just to make it look like a real jar. Just a heads up too, like this line back here, like the edge of this lip behind your sparklers, you're not gonna paint over your sparkler, okay? This line in front, right? We want the lip of our jar to go around the front and behind these guys, okay? So on this part, we're gonna paint over the line, okay? The front of our jar. The back of our jar is going to go behind these lines. So I want you to skip. Okay. Curve around, skip over. Don't paint over your sparklers. Okay. So I'm going to take my teeny tiny princess brush. I'm going to rinse mine off just because I'm in the habit of rinsing off my brushes. I just leave my brushes in my jar of water there so that I have easy access to clean brushes. I'm in the habit of doing that. If you are into painting or would like to get into painting, I encourage you to do the same. Okay, so same teeny tiny princess brush. I'm going to load it up with my white here. And I'm going to go back over the lines I marked out for my jar so that we have proportional jar here. I'm going to go behind my sparklers there. Okay, don't paint over the sparklers in the back. My little mason jar has little ribs on the edge of the lip of my glass. And they do have those rungs around it, right? To make sure you can secure your lid. Here is the front of my jar here. I'm going to go around my edges and down. If you pick up some of your blue, that's okay. If you completely cover some of your blue, that's okay too. Let it go. Allow yourself permission to mess up. Okay, and then I'm going to add some highlights here. This part is optional. You don't have to do this if you don't want to. I just find that when I add highlights, it really just adds to the realism, right? Kind of as close as I can get it without it looking too cartoony. Gentle, gentle, gentle. Maybe just this curve here. Maybe I want the outside here. And you guys, if it's a little bit crooked, that's okay. Okay, it's a painting. Art is an expression. Maybe I want a nice reflection here, right across the center. Maybe I want just scrabble. Maybe I've got some reflections down here too. I am going to go over this emblem here as well. Kind of want more reflections in my glass here, though, before I go over those lines. Again, try not to think about it too much. It's too late, Kaui. We've already done that. Don't tell me what to do. Yeah. Okay. So I'm going to go back over my little emblem here. Very gently. In the '80s, babies, leave your mark. All right, there's my jar. I want this jar to be more crisp. I want the edges to be a little crisper than they are. I'm going to brighten up this line here. Awesome. Here too. I want to brighten up this line here. Okay, from here, what we're going to do is, again, I'm going to use my finger. You're going to use your medium brush if you don't want to get your hands dirty, but I'm going to touch my white. I'm going to touch the center of this firecracker, and I'm just going to circle out just a little bit until the center kind of hazes, okay? Again, if you don't want to use your finger, please use your medium brush. And then what we're going to do is we're going to scrabble the edges, okay? So whichever one is your favorite finger, okay. This is my favorite finger. I'm just going to touch the center of my firecracker there, and I'm just going to circle out a little bit. And this is just to brighten up the center of our sparkler. Okay. Okay. So from here, we're gonna take our teeny tiny princess brush and we are going to pull out just tiny hairs, okay? Out from each direction here. And I'm gonna use my white paint here. I'm gonna use my teeny tiny princess brush and white. And I like very gently, I'm just gonna pull out random lines and a little bit further than the edges of my sparkler.
We do want it to be kind of hazy and a little bit messy. Very, very gentle. If you run out of paint, load up again. And then you guys, if you get ahead of me, you're just going to scrabble the edges of your circle there so that it looks kind of like an asterisk on steroids. Okay, and then where my dot is, I am just very gently going to scrabble the edges. So that it doesn't look like a perfect circle. Okay, all right, so same thing with my yellow and blue. I'm gonna take my same teeny tiny princess brush. I'm gonna load it up with white. And from the center here, I'm just gonna cut in tiny hairs. All over. Past the edge of my yellow here. They sparkle hard. Oops, not that color. Dang. Okay, and then I'm gonna scrabble my edges here. Scrabble. So they kind of look like those little soots from Spirited Away. Little ashen soot balls. Okay, and then the last part is blue. Same teeny tiny princess brush, white. If you load out of paint, run up again. Goodness gracious. Words are hard today. What is up with me today? Tripping over my words, whole entire lesson. Amateur. Just kidding. And then you guys, same thing, I'm gonna scrabble. If you still have like a perfect circle here, I want you to scrabble the edges so that it doesn't look like a perfect circle, okay? Okay, and then you guys, from here, little sparkles. Okay? And you guys, just a heads up too, like, you do want them to sort of be all over the place, okay? Just think about how a sparkler gives off its sparkles. They're just going to fly everywhere, okay? So if they're crooked and uneven, it's okay. They should be. Hold on. Let me hang up on this person really quick. but we are going to put in, we'll put in some stars here, just a couple of asterisks, and some kind of splashy marks, okay? And then the rest, it's totally up to you. You can put your dots wherever they belong, but I'm going to take my same teeny tiny princess brush and white. And I'm just going to decide where my biggest sparkles are. And to do them, I'm going to make an asterisk, okay? So across, right, and then an X. However many or few you have, however big or small they are, there's no right answer. And wherever they live in your painting. All right, so there's my sparkles. I'm gonna put in my splashy sparks here as just kind of uneven dots. All right, think about how a sparkler shines, gives off its sparks. They kind of just go wherever. Splashy sparkles. Wherever your splashy sparkles belong.
Cool.
Okay, and then from here, same teeny tiny princess brush, we're just going to put in a couple of dots. Okay? Again, however many or few you have. But these are just kind of filler dots, okay? They're just tiny, tiny little dots to really just round out your painting here. Again, try not to think about it too much. Think of them as tiny stars in your sky. Maybe some go in your sparkler there. Maybe you have a galaxy of sparkles. Maybe it's that kind of day. Yeah. It's a party. It's a blast. And that is it, my beautiful humans. Give yourselves a hand. Well done. Good job. Please don't forget to sign your painting so we know who the culprit is. I'm gonna use yellow. Maybe I'm not. Yes, I am. Awesome. All right, you guys, if you would like to learn more about painting, you're welcome to join my online course. It is Paint Class Online. If you liked this painting, please leave a comment in the comments below. If you would like to show my tip jar some love, it is right there on the YouTube panel. You can hit the thanks button, or you can go to my PayPal. It's paypal.me/Kaui Wilson. Also, these lives are only going to be up for a couple of days, and then they are going to Patreon. If you would like access to my entire course, as well as all the lives, you are welcome to join us on Patreon. Again, it's just Kaui Wilson. Or you can join paintclass.online and learn everything that I know and then some. We're always adding on. And these lives will also be in that library. Thank you, thank you, thank you so much for showing up today. I hope you had a great time. If you are interested, I would love it if you followed me on Facebook. We have a private group where you can post your paintings, okay? I would love, love, love to see your finished works. So if you haven't already, please follow me on Facebook and shoot me a message if you would like to of your painting. I want to see your painting. That's all. I love you guys. Thank you so much for showing up today. Be well.